That was good, wasn't it? It was brilliant, wasn't it? Brian was a bit nervous there, wasn't he?
He was, but he's a good lad, Brian. He'll get used to it.
Okay. And then what have we got now? Let's see. While we were in America a couple of weeks ago, we actually did a piece on a friend of ours. Remember Pete Dawson?
Oh, I remember Pete very well, yeah. Do you remember him?
Who?
Pete. No, Pete Dawson was actually, he auditioned for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest and did some rehearsals as Dale Harding. But unfortunately, he was still waiting for his visa to get into America because he's going up there to marry his good lady friend or wife or...
Well, it's his wife. Huh?
Yeah, it's his wife.
He actually emigrated to New Jersey in America because he was getting married to a lady he'd met, and we happened to just be in the area. We made a 200-mile detour to call in just for a cup of coffee.
Yeah, we surprised him, didn't we?
We certainly did. So have a look at this piece of film here. Yeah.
I knew, I had a feeling, because when you sent me an email and you said we're looking for your address on Google Earth and stuff.
I know.
That was what's that about? You never...
That was a hoax, that, mate.
Where are you staying?
We're on our way home now.
Oh, you're on your way back?
Yeah.
Right.
But we said, like, we'll call in.
We want to present you with a certificate from Vesbim TV Productions and stuff. That's yours. Can you identify this painting?
Yeah, that's my dad's painting.
There you go. And can you identify this poster?
Never seen that before in my life.
We'll take it, we'll tell you all about it. Yes,
we've only called in for a coffee.
Yeah, they're on the way to Newark Airport. They're going home now. They've been here for a week.
So, anyway, Mr. Harding, you actually thought you had escaped, and we've found you and discovered you're hiding out in New Jersey. What do you have to say for yourself?
What I have to say for myself is this: try and make it stick, copper. Because there's no deportation rules in this state. So you'll never take me alive. Okay.
Never. We'll call back next week then.
You can tell that Mac Murphy fella, I'm glad they done for him. I'm glad they done for him.
Well, that was really good as well, wasn't it? That was good.
Yeah, it wasn't bad. Short but sweet, but there you go.
Well, international.
Says hello to everyone. Yeah. Beep, dap, dap,
dap. You do the what?
You would what now?
So, as you probably know, Vesbim TV is basically international based. You probably noticed the lovely suntan that I'm sporting.
Yeah.
Because last week I beamed out to go to Cyprus. Went to Pathos.
Pathos?
Yeah.
Is he one of the musketeers?
No.
Oh, isn't he? Okay.
It's hard work working with an ignoramus, but we'll get there, you know. Yeah. We're an equal opportunities organisation here at Vesbim, and that's why we have this person here. There's probably a village doing without a good idiot.
Oh my God. Yeah, go on, carry on, will you?
So, what's this about Facebook? While I've been away, he's been fiddling around on the computer. What's this about Facebook?
Well, I got arrested for that. Facebook, well, Paula Rowlands, a very good friend who's with Out the Bag Productions.
Out the Bag Productions?
Out the Bag Productions.
Aren't they on the Carlton Theatre this week?
They are, they're on tonight, actually. Their last show is tonight.
What do you do?
Twisted Angels.
Again?
Again, yeah.
Well, Twisted Angels is about prostitution and comedy and tragedy. It's a fantastic play.
It is a fantastic
play. And when's it out again?
I think it's October. We'll give you the dates next week. But anyway, going back to Facebook, before I was rudely interrupted by this monkey here, Paul set up a group on Facebook for us, Vesbim TV, and all this is to do with supporting our TV station, which is the number one TV station in the world at the moment. So if you log on to Facebook, join our group. We're trying to get as many members as we can. So.
So you five viewers, tell your friends. You'll probably also notice that every week that I'm here, I actually wear a hat of some description. Well, the problem is, I've gone prematurely grey.
Prematurely? You've been grey for ages.
Since I've met Alan.
Yeah, it's true that. Yeah.
And it affects the lighting, so I have to wear a hat. Look at this. So I always wear a hat. That's it. Is that the news?
That's a great bit of information, that, mate. It's a great bit of news as well. A scoop, a scoop that Phil has gone grey.
Yeah, speaking of scoops, which reminds me of poop scoops, can you say poo without smiling?
Yeah, sure.
Go on then.
Poo.
Poo. Try that home, folks.
Poo.
Bye, see you next week.
Ta-da, here's the weather.
Anyway, Alan, what's the weather like?
Let me tell you. The sun's up, the sky's blue, there's not a cloud to spoil the view, but it's raining. It's raining in my heart.
The sun is out, the sky is blue. There's not a cloud to spoil the view, but it's raining, raining in my heart. The weatherman says clear today, he doesn't know you've gone away, and it's raining, raining in my heart. Oh, misery, misery. What's gonna become of me? I tell my blues they mustn't show, but soon these tears are bound to flow, 'cause it's raining, raining in my heart. But it's raining, raining in my heart. It's raining, raining in my heart. Oh, misery, misery. What's gonna become of me? I tell my blues they mustn't show.